Crowbar, are you going to wrestle me at Starrcade?
It would be my honor, Terry.
What are they doing to Nash now?
They're going for the knee.
What a sacrifice by the Sarge. He had to go through hell to get Lex Luger on Thunder.
Give me the key to the car.
He T-boned him on a table, and that's the prelude for the Steiner Recliner.
Hey, Steiner, come and get down.
Uh-oh. Is this what we can expect at Starrcade?
Welcome to Thunder. Welcome to my show. On Nitro, I promised Sarge Dwayne Bruce a shot at Lex Luger. Now, the guys that broke into the business when I did back in 98, they know that I'm a man of my word. Sarge, you will get your shot tonight, right here on this show. Now, another important piece of business that I should have took care of on Nitro, we got ourselves a cruiserweight champion, Chavo Guerrero Jr. Beat me. Now, tonight, I've got a little something special in store for him. Tonight, Chavo, you will be facing the perfect event. Now, I would recommend that you go find yourself a partner. Now, if you can't find yourself a partner, I guess it'll be you against the perfect event in a nice little handicap match. Thank you.
Oh, man, Mike Sanders, can you see me? Can you hear me? It's Ric Flair, the CEO, your boss talking to you. Mike, that show that you've just laid out sounds spectacular. I'm just going to add my own personal touch to a few things. First of all, I want you to make sure Lance Storm sings the national anthem live here on Thunder tonight. Secondly, my plan to keep Steiner and Vicious apart on Nitro didn't exactly work out the way I wanted it to. So tonight, Mike, I know Scott Steiner, the champion's in the building. I know Sid's on his way. If they want to have at it right here tonight on Thunder, I'm all for it. No holds barred. If Sid gets here and they get locked up, they can have Starrcade right here tonight on Thunder. That's how fed up I am with trying to keep them apart. They want at it, they can have it. And then third, Mike, let me tell you this. The only problem I have with you as a commissioner, sometimes you abuse your power. The deal with Chavo is out of control. So this is what I'm gonna do, because you are not only the commissioner, you are a big star working hard for this company. I think you need to wrestle tonight too. And there's a guy out there by the name of Diamond Dallas Page. Whew, the Diamond Cutter. Looking for a tough match, and he's got you tonight right here on Thunder, Mike. Go get him, pal. You're the commissioner. You got DDP.
These teams tore down the house.
house last month at Mayhem. They'll have the opportunity this Sunday, and you have to wonder, will this divide the winning team, the person that gets that cruiserweight shot?
Opening up with a tag team matchup here.
Boom, nice.
Double team. I thought this was him. I'm going
to
say this.
Scheduled to be a three-way dance. I was waiting for the third team, and here come the Young Dragons.
These guys may not be the tallest or the heaviest, but they're without among the most talented in this promotion, and they're proving it once again. It's on and cracking.
Dance high. Oh, my goodness.
On and cracking?
It's on and cracking, dog.
I know what he meant. Up on top, as you saw Lea Meow come in.
Oh, there's a fabulous one, Lea Meow.
Lea Meow makes her way down as the Dragons are already here. A three-way dance. You're going to see these three teams in that ladder match coming up. Starcade. It's reverse neck grip. It is only now, Mike, 4 days away. It has always been the focal point of the entire year for WCW.
That's Evan Courageous calls that driving the caddy and getting on his cell and talking to his honeys. You know, Evan Courageous was in soap operas like All My Children. He did print ads for Calvin Klein, and it's really gotten to his head.
You're not kidding. What an egomaniac he is, and he just unleashed a right hand that took Sugar Shane Helms down to the mat.
He also went to a movie premiere last week with Wesley Snipes, who he says is a good friend of his.
He was bragging about all day.
He's always bragging about being a big Hollywood star. I haven't seen him do anything yet, but you never know.
He's hammering on his Shane Helms.
Oh, nice.
That time, partners collide. Courageous.
Always coming up with innovative and creative moves. These three teams are among the most talented in WCW.
Wow.
What a super kick.
Shane Helms, great extension. No, got a hook of a far leg and could not get the pin that time. On Jamie Noble, tag is made, and here comes Shannon Moore. Who's going to be the one man to climb up the ladder and reach and get the shot at the WCW Cruiserweight title? We're going to have to work as teams, Mike, during the ladder match this coming Sunday, but then it's going to really be every man for himself.
Yeah, that's exactly what it's going to be. Teams.
Oh, nice suplex.
Where they go for that envelope, they have to climb the ladder. The one person will emerge from Starcade is the number one contender to the Cruiserweight title.
Let me tell you something about Shannon, who's from Cameron, North Carolina. He's 21 years old. He was telling me that when he first started, he used to practice on a trampoline. They used to videotape all the matches and sell them at local video stores.
Tag made. Tilt-a-whirl back.
Nice tilt-a-whirl.
Cass Hayashi elevates Shannon Moore. Drops him on his lower back that time. And it's Jamie Noble.
Roll up.
Sunset Flip attempt.
Oh, nice.
Great escape, man. That time, Kaz with a back leg front kick. Kaz Noble in the head. Watch out.
Nice. Kaz Hayashi, who wrestled the Mexican promo Azteca Shiru and wore a mask, also trained in Japan.
Here, look at this.
Whoa, a little bit of a preview, maybe, for the ladder match Sunday at Starcade.
Nice. Nice variation of the Glory Special invented by Chavo Guerrero's grandfather.
And he dropped
Glory
him
Guerrero.
On, he dropped him on the back of his head, that inverted Glory Special that time. Over the top.
Nice, oh, nice.
Sensational flip dive by Shane Helms took out Yang.
They might both be hurt. Here comes a lot of bam, midsection.
We're 4 days out from Starcade, and one man will get a chance to go on. Look at this.
4 days before Starcade, and they ain't holding nothing back, Tony.
But should they be? I mean, to put a ladder in, this is so much risk they're taking right now.
Hey, this is the big time. You can't be asking about what's going to happen tomorrow. You got to worry about today.
Calls that move the bottoms up, and he just took Courageous and drove him face first to the canvas. Now he's got the ladder, positioning it in the corner.
What is he going to do here? This is so dangerous for either man. For the man up top and the man on the bottom. Shannon Moore, Jamie Noble. Jamie Noble cuts him off. Oh, that time he dropped his knee across the steel turnbuckle. Noble has Shannon Moore. Wait a minute, look at Evan up on top.
Look at this, they're balanced up on the ladder.
Oh no.
The Noble and this... Courageous.
They're going to break their neck.
Oh, my God. These guys could all fall off outside of the ring, and this will be all Archie Rope. Here we go.
Oh, bam!
Nice.
Flexed him back into the ring off the top of the ladder.
All three of them are evenly hurt, Tony.
All three took the blow. You're right, K-Dog, at the same time. And who...
Uh-oh, little dissension in the ranks here.
Hot dog, one, two, three.
Boom.
Well, there's been dissension ever since this team was formed.
Evans driving that caddy again on the celly cell. Do your thing, Doss. This kid's too much. Uh-oh.
He does the same thing at Starrcade coming up on Sunday. We're going to see a little bit more dissension. But remember, once they get the ladder, it's every man for himself, and it's starting right now.
You know, Paisley, there is only one thing my tough machine is missing.
Yeah, I know exactly what it needs.
A little bit of pink.
Quee-wee, only a real tough guy can handle a pink machine. What are you laughing at, Bree?
Like anything is going to make Quee-wee look like a tough guy.
Medeja, I'm tougher than you, little girl, so you have a lot of nerve to get in my face.
Ladies, don't make me angry. Don't. Freak! Nobody touch my freak! You got that? Don't ever touch my freak! Don't ever touch my freak! You want to go for a ride on your little... Boring. You want to go for another ride? You want to go for another ride? What? What? Don't touch my freak! Nobody touch my freak!
Hey fans, this holiday season, Enhanced TBS and WCW Thunder are taking you for a ride. We've teamed up to bring you the chance to win a Yamaha Kodiak 4x4 ATV, the one you just saw in the Enhanced TBS Hardcore Holiday Sweepstakes. Enter, log on to TBSSuperstation.com and click on Enhanced TBS to get your entry number. The Enhanced TBS Hardcore Holiday Sweepstakes. Celebrate the season off-road style.
Anybody, you know, I promised the fans tonight. You sing the national anthem, the American national anthem.
The problem is, Rick, I don't know the words. I don't want to disrespect your national anthem. Now, I go out there, it'll be a disgrace on your whole country. I don't know the words. It's going to be a disgrace.
No, I promise.
I don't know the words. It'll be very disrespectful, Rick.
No, we'll make it right. Take your time. You'll learn the words. We'll make it work. Come on.
I haven't got time to learn the words.
I promise.
Wait. I got an idea. I'll teach you the words, lad. Oh, say, can you see? I'll teach you the words. I got it, Rick. I'll teach you, lad.
Thanks, Jim. Okay, Jim. Be sure to get your Slap Nuts t-shirt, WCWgear.com, 1-800-929-8661. As the holiday season is rapidly approaching, Starrcade always a part of the holidays. It seemed to me that Lance Storm was trying to get out of singing the Star Spangled Banner, but here comes Hacks
over the Jay Brown's been in the U.S. for like 3 or 4 years, and he don't know the national anthem?
Well, he's from Canada. And Canada is his homeland, as we see the new cruiserweight champ, Chavo Guerrero Jr., make his way to the ring. And, wow, Commissioner Sanders sure didn't give Chavo much time to find a tag team partner. I wonder if he was successful.
I'm sure he heard the national anthem enough times when we were kicking their butt in the Olympics.
Well, Chavo does not have a lot of friends around here, and now he must...
Chavo Guerrero comes from a great dynasty because besides his grandfather, the great Gory Guerrero, who was the greatest lightweight champion in the history of Mexico, as you know, over there, they're divided into divisions, lightweight, middleweight, just like boxing. His uncle, his father, Chavo, was a wrestler. His uncle, Eddie, Mondo, Hector, Donner, Blitzen, and I think Rudolph, too.
Yeah, looks like, be that as it may, he's... Have many friends here. Looks like he's flying solo against the World Tag Team Champions. They received the belts, a gift thanks to Commissioner Mike Sanders a week ago, and they must defend the belts against the Insiders, DDP. Kevin Nash coming up in a mere 4 days, Mike.
We got three champs in the ring.
Certainly a matchup we're looking forward to at Starrcade, and Chavo Guerrero Jr. here. I think this is a little bit of payback for the fact that he defeated Commissioner Mike Sanders last week on this program to capture the cruiserweight title, and now the deck is being stacked, obviously in the favor of the Thrillers and the Perfect Event team of Stasiak and Palumbo in what has boiled down to now a handicap match.
Well, Chuck and Sean Stasiak, big favorites at all the local bathhouses, but you got Chavo over here who was a bartender in Southern California, and he won like it was called a bar flare competition. He's flipping bottles like Tom Cruise did in the movie Cocktail. Just a little added info there.
You're just a fountain of information tonight, K-Dog.
Just trying to do my best.
Chavo, the cruiserweight champion, and Stasiak, much taller man, sends him down.
Snaps off the flying head scissors, follows it up with a drop kick, and not doing too bad.
Look at this. The Misfits in action, watching on. The leader, of course, General Rexon, we saw on Tuesday night on TNT. Chavo going nose to nose, general erection, and there is the pitfalls of being one on two. Colombo pulling down the top rope, Chavo on the outside.
Yeah, certainly a difference in philosophy as of late between Chavo Guerrero Jr. and the other members of the Misfits in action, as we see great teamwork here from the perfect event.
I'll tell you what, Sanders showed no mercy putting in Chavo Guerrero against the Wolves because Chavo beat him for the title, but that's the way Mike Sanders works. Let me ask you a question, Tony. Now, if Ric Flair is the CEO, why can't he just fire average
Mike? No, sit down.
I don't have an answer for that, but we're looking at, you know, check Lash out the, wants to go help.
Yeah, see the concern from Lash LaRue, Corporal Cajun?
General Rexman and let him go.
Well, Lash was the closest to him as far as, you know, being good friends in the MIAs.
General Rexman did not look happy at all, and there's a roundhouse right from Palumbo. But right now, Chavo, for as great of a cruiserweight champion that he is going in against two of the best heavyweights, the world tag team champions. Sanders said, get you a partner. I think Sanders realized he had no friends.
Tony, do you think that Lance will disobey general reaction and go in the ring and help Chavo? Nice move.
Great
nice
move, Chavo.
A variation of a neck breaker. There's no way Chavo can win this.
Well, one would think, but he has risen to the occasion many, many times.
Every time he covers one guy, the other guy breaks it up, Tony.
Oh! Into the top turnbuckle pin, Chavo. He's turning it around once again.
How can he win like this, Tony? How can he expect to win?
Now, Conan, I don't think he can expect to win, but you know there's a lot of fight left into Chavo, Lieutenant Loco, whatever you want to call him. A lot of fight.
And he's going to need a lot of fight against the World Tag Team Champions, the perfect event. Palumbo's series of right hands to the side of the head, sends him into the turnbuckle, and then turns things over to his tag partner, Sean Stasiak.
How about what went down on Tuesday night on Nitro when the insiders were hammered thanks to the Metro-born Thrillers and what they did to the knee of Kevin Nash?
What about that knee? Is it going to be 100% for Starrcade when they challenge for the tag belts?
Through the legs of time, Chavo Jr. picked up by Stasiak. Chavo fighting. Crawley's right up top. Can he?
Nice! That might be it. And you know what? Sanders is vicious. He put Chavo in there knowing he was outmanned. And this might be it. All she wrote. There we go.
Chavo 1-2.
Nice! Chavo. Wow.
Stasiak thought he should have won it.
Chavo Jr. digging down deep, able to kick out and avoid the pinfall from Stasiak.
I can't help but wonder if Lash will come out and disobey general reaction.
General Rexion.
Whatever his name might be
Lash's reaction.
General Schwarzkopf, whatever his name is, you know who I'm talking about.
He's the leader of MIA, and look at Chavo again. He does not know how to stop.
There's no stopping in him, no quit.
Palumbo wanted to come in.
You might even see an upset, Tony.
Scott James, the referee, sends Palumbo back to the corner. You're right, it would be an upset, even though they're all champions. You got to wonder what's going through the mind right now of General Rex. You know what's going through the mind of Corporal Cajun. He wants to get in there. But for Rex,
by his body language, you could tell Tony wants to go in there and help Chavo. They were very close.
Yeah, it's got to be killing him right now not to be able to help him out.
I cannot believe Chavo's lasted this long. Oh. Look at him. And he's still, you know, he's still going at it. Here we go with some drop kicks off the third. Missile drop kick. Oh, no. He came off with a flying body press.
Flying body press and almost got the pin. And he was quick enough to roll out of the way. Palumbo connected with his own man with the elbow.
That's
going
it.
Up again. Count him.
Referee slow to count.
You're not kidding. That should have been a free count. And then he turned around and he got glommed by Stasiak with the clothesline.
You think the ref could be paid off by average Mike also?
You never know how deep the pockets are of Commissioner Mike Sanders. Into the ropes goes the cruiserweight champ again. He tries his best to get the big man Stasiak down, but he's in his clutches. Oh, look at that. What a spectacular double team. Holding up Chavo for Palumbo to drop, kicking back towards the neutral corner.
Gutsy game effort from Chavo Guerrero Jr., but it looks like the numbers are just too strong.
Oh, he pulled him up.
They're trying to teach him a lesson now.
And you wonder what's going to the mind now.
Come on, Huey's alone, man. That's not what being a team is about. I got to do
something. Hey, he's alone because he chose to be alone. He needs to learn a lesson. And you need to learn a lesson. So you sit down and you pay attention.
A little tough love from the general.
Well, he's right.
Yeah, well, maybe he is. Up and down.
Nobody kicks out of that. This is it.
Double
this has got to be it.
Pick pinning combination. Ooh. 1, 2, 3.
Hey, right. Chavo put up a good fight, guys.
Props to Chavo Jr. Even in defeat. Fight.
Very well said. He did give it everything. Did Chavo Guerrero Jr. But the perfect event prevails in this handicap match. For them, 4 days out, Diamond Dallas Page, Kevin Nash, for the WCW Tag Team Championship. Thunder continues. It's our last stop before we go to Starcade. Ladies and gentlemen, Conan, good to have you with us. Ric Flair said, Mike, Conan, that Sid Vicious was on his way to the arena. Scott Steiner is here, and he is going to now just let him go at it. Open up the floodgates, so to speak, if they can tonight.
You never know what's going to go on with these two individuals. A lot of bad blood. You saw what happened in the parking lot. Who knows what's going to happen in the arena?
Turn them loose. That's what the CEO, Ric Flair, said, and I think everybody, as we head into Starcade, wants to see Sid Vicious versus Big Papa Pump Scott Steiner.
Good call by Rick.
Okay, we said Sid Vicious was en route, and I do believe we have been attempting to contact Sid on his cell phone
right
now.
Guys, can you hear me?
Yeah, Sid.
Can you hear me?
Sid, how far are you away here from the arena?
I'm not very far away. If you'll just wait, don't let anything happen.
Uh-oh.
Don't let Scott Steiner leave that building. I won't, Scott Steiner. Guys, I will be there. The traffic's a little messed up right now, but I'm just 10 or 15 minutes away. So hold things if you can.
So obviously you know what Ric Flair said. You guys can go at it tonight. He's not going to hold you back any longer.
Oh, did he say that?
Yes, he did.
I'll be there. You just keep things on the shelf, Tony.
Okay, I sure will, Sid. What a wild end to Nitro we had last night, didn't we?
Out of control. Ric Flair has given them a green light, and Sid's on the way.
We'll be right back on TBS. Don't you dare go away.
See the stars of WCW live in action this Saturday, December 16th, St. Paul, Minnesota. Tickets go on sale for Nitro Live. Fort Wayne, Indiana. Get your Nitro tickets this Saturday, December 16th. Starcade is coming to Washington, D.C. this Sunday, December 17th. Tickets are going fast. At Richmond, Virginia, Nitro is headed your way next Monday, December 18th. Tickets are on sale now. WCW is live. Don't miss it.
Hey! What happened? What happened,
Steiner
people?
Steiner!
You stay here and take care of Greenlee. I'll go look for Steiner. Nobody touches that to my friend. Hey, Steiner!
Hey, baby, what's up? How you doing? Hey, what do you think?
Like a guy like me go out with a girl like you?
What?
Come on now.
What do I think?
Yeah, what do you think?
That's what I think.
What'd you have to do that for?
What are you doing, man? What
is the matter?
Come here. Come on, man. Throw me in this thing here. Come here.
We'll mess with our sister, you understand?
Come on, let's get out of here.
Sarge, after what Lex Luger did to you and Goldberg on Nitro, I think this guy has sunk to an all-time low. However, good news, a shot at revenge. As you face Lex Luger here tonight, and quite candidly, I think he's underestimating you.
That's right, Gene. I tell you what, I know he has, because I took guys a lot bigger than Lex and made them puke and crawl on their hands and knees out to their car to get away from me. And I'm going to tell you one thing. I can't wait to get my hands on him and put him through hell. But I tell you, it's one thing wrestling me tonight, but it'd be a different thing wrestling Bill this Sunday.
All right, I thank you. Goldberg's mentor, the Sarge, is going to be facing Lex Luger here tonight.
Lex, you gotta sing it like you mean it. Oh, say, can you see?
Who's Jose? I thought this was...
No, not Jose. Oh, say!
I can't do this, Jim. I can't do
this. You can do it. You just gotta work at it. Sing from the heart.
And later on in this telecast, the total package will face Sarge Dwayne Bruce. He doesn't seem to be concerned about the match at all now, does he?
Not at all. He's yawning. Can you be overconfident?
We're only 4 days away from the granddaddy of them all. Starcade comes up this Sunday from the MCI Center. It's maniac against maniac. Scott Steiner, Big Papa Pump, is still the WCW champion.
There's only one Scott Steiner. There's only one world champion.
I'm coming out after your ass.
Ain't nobody can protect nobody from Scott Steiner. You're one of the wrestlers!
is a man who has put people out with injuries, who's ended careers.
I put his ass in the hospital.
Nobody can protect the referees from Scott Steiner.
Not a chance. I put Sting in the hospital.
Sting is in severe trouble here.
Don't let this happen.
No.
I put Booker T in the hospital.
Oh, he cracked it with the pipe. He's going for the knee.
Booker T is hurt bad.
He cannot be controlled.
I gave Goldberg his first defeat of his career.
Scott Steiner wins one of the most ball-busting matches you'll ever see.
And he don't want no more me.
Steiner is way out there, gone like Pluto, baby.
Nobody's safe.
I always wonder who Scott Steiner's going to kill every night.
Scott Steiner is out of control.
You walk away, and I won't put you in the hospital.
Scott Steiner's going to put him in the hospital.
There's the Steiner recliner, and that is it.
Will Steiner's reign of terror continue?
I'll come after you.
Scott, you can go too far.
Come on, Scott!
This is a madman.
See the power.
That's why they call me Big Papa.
But for the madman Scott Steiner, 4 days out, he'll face a man equally as mad. Sid Vicious, WCW title on the line. It is one of the biggest world title matches in recent memory. And it's all for you this coming Sunday. It's on pay-per-view, Starrcade 2000 from the MCI Center. And we're coming back on TBS.
We should get going.
Yeah, we're going to roll, Goldberg.
Going?
You guys ain't going nowhere. Listen, you smucky punches. We got lots and lots of Hanukkah left. We're going to smoke salmon and Inca filter fish, and if you don't like it, I'll turn your kiskas into Kreplok. Oh, and later.
I want Steiner. What do you have done?
Meng, he's out of control.
Exactly. What he's done to my friends, you know, like Arn Anderson and what he did for Gwee-Wee. What's going on with
him?
I want to wrestle him.
You sure you want him?
Yes.
You got it, brother. Come on, Meng.
I want him. I want him now.
You got it tonight. You got it.
Whatever you're going to
do. You got a shot at the world title tonight right here on Thunder.
Are you sure enough?
There it is. Ric Flair has given Meng a world title shot. Log on to WCWgear.com. Get your Lance Storm, Don't Play Canada t-shirt. 1-800-990-8661. How about Meng and how about Lance Storm's problems with the cat?
Yeah, those problems with the cat surfaced this past week on Nitro. The cat and Ms. Jones won a mixed tag team match over this man, Lance Storm, and Major Guns. And as a result of the pre-match stipulation, Lance Storm must sing the U.S. National Anthem tonight here on Thunder. And a little problem with Hacksaw Jim Duggan in the 2x4 on Nitro.
You think he learned the words to the National Anthem yet?
He was getting cue cards, couldn't we?
I think he's going to butcher this thing up, is what I think. And probably do it on purpose.
Well, Hacksaw can help him out.
There's prime time. It's my house. Hee-hee-hee.
You better be serious for a moment here. This is the Star Spangled Banner coming up.
If I can be serious for a minute.
Oh, good, he is.
I'm out here because Canadians are men of their word. The question you need to ask yourselves is, would the cat be out here if positions were reversed?
Of course he would.
I think not. Because Americans don't have any integrity. Now, if I gotta do this, let's do this. So hit the American National Anthem.
Mike, why'd you say he?
I was thinking about, wait a minute, that's not the American National Anthem, is it?
You're right, it's not. That's the cat's music.
And that's the cat and Ms. Jones. What have they got? Is that a picnic basket?
Yeah, maybe they're bringing us some food.
Okay, wait a minute.
I was kind of looking at the flags.
Turn the music off.
What are they doing?
Looks like they're going to have a picnic.
Now, wait a minute. If you think I'm not going to come out here and enjoy this, you must be out of your damn mind. I want to watch and listen to you three Susans in there sing this song right here. I'm going to tell you something too, Lance Storm. If you don't sing it right, I'm going to
No, I'm not gonna say it. I'm not gonna stick these flags anywhere, okay?
Very patriotic.
I'm not gonna say it. But just sing the song. Get this show on.
He and Miss Jones are gonna enjoy it.
What a brutal t-shirt design Lance Storm has. I don't know what's worse, his or Jeff Jarrett's.
He's missed about 4 or 5 bars already.
Oh, hey, can you see by the dawn's early light? Blah, blah, blah.
Hey, wait a minute.
Cut it out.
That was a little off-key.
Blah, blah, blah.
He was improvising.
Lance Storm, I'm going to tell you something. I'm going to give you one more chance to sing this song right. Now, if you don't, the nice sound these people hearing here going to be my foot banging against your Canadian ass. Now, sing this song right.
I think Francis Scott Key wrote blah, blah, blah.
Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so gallantly seen? Maybe you don't know the word, but hey, you Dumpy.
Dumpy?
Hey, Mike, you got a bucket?
I know you know the words. I know you know. Why don't you help him out, you traitor?
I'll be glad to sing the American National Anthem.
Yeah.
Oh. Is he having a change of heart?
Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early? So proudly we hail a music of twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous.
There you go. At one time, he was a great patriot. It's not evident by that singing, though.
Look at the cat's
That's enough.
Hot dogs
I've played your game long enough. You want to fight, Cat? You want to fight? You fight Duggan.
Fight Duggan?
You fight Duggan.
He's gonna fight Storm at Starrcade in 4 days.
And the people are rabid.
Hey,
listen to them.
I guess what? I tell you what. The American people here want to see me fight. So we have spoken. I'm gonna kick some ass right now.
He's gonna take on Duggan. And we're gonna have that match when we come back on Thunder.
Every year, there is one event that rises above all others. One night that destroys the past, defines the future, and twists around everything you thought you knew into a night you will never forget. This year, that event is Starrcade. You cannot imagine what WCW will do on its biggest night until you see it live. Order Starrcade, Sunday, December 17th at 8 Eastern, live and only on pay-per-view.
The bell sounds. We're back on Thunder. It's the Cat against Hacksaw Jim Duggan of Team Canada.
What's this? Duggan just turned his back on the Cat.
I have no idea, but I mean, Mike, you talked about Duggan's 2x4 being very instrumental in Lance Storm having to sing the Star Spangled Banner.
Well, I'm just wondering, is Hacksaw Jim Duggan finally coming to his senses in this storm?
What's Jim telling Lance?
They've had nothing but communication problems for the past couple of weeks. And again, they've resurfaced here on Thunder.
Do you think Duggan's having a change of heart?
I don't know. I don't know if it's more of a change of heart than it is a disagreement with the leader of Team Canada. And now you see Primetime. He's got the Cat.
Well, Cat's almost in the same position Chavo was against the Thrillers. He's just outmanned here. Too many people.
Too many people. It's a good call, Conan. They're chanting USA. And they're chanting USA.
Oh, wait a minute. Oh. Not over here. With
the world.
Wait, he's pushing him away from the Cat.
What's gotten into Duggan?
Does he want to fight him himself?
I guess he does. He wants to be his own man.
Oh,
and the Cat
hit him anyways.
That's right. And he turns around and there's Lance Storm.
Yeah, look, who's with who here?
Duggan wants to be his own man, apparently. He wants to win this match on his own accord. And there's nothing wrong with that. You wouldn't even agree with that, Mike.
Well, almost as if being successful and being happy are two different things.
You know that Primetime wrote the lyrics up to Michael Jackson's Beat It? Did you know that?
Didn't know that.
But yes.
Yeah, once again,
it's
you're
my house.
He's full of factoids, isn't he?
Mr. Yes. Factoid K-Dog.
Oh, the 2x4 by Duggan. He's got his trademark, and he goes deep into the gut of the cat. Duggan manhandling the cat here.
Oh, he had second thoughts.
Oh, look at that hacksaw. Hacksaw, come home, we love you.
Facial expression, say it all. Wait a minute, he just got stoned on the back swing.
I think he meant to do that. He's pretending he did it. I think he did. I think he did.
I'm not so sure by that reaction if Duggan meant to or not.
Too much of a coincidence.
Major Guns taking on the leader.
He's straight to the fans. Look at him.
Duggan back end. Kind of like the Duggan of old here.
Going to take the jersey off.
Take it off. That's what the people want. Oh, Cat hit him anyway.
Cat kicked him with a jersey over his head, and it gives the Cat the win.
You know what? Cat doesn't know if this was a ruse if they were setting this up, so he did the right thing.
The Cat wins over Duggan, who was taking the jersey of Team Canada, the Maple Leafs, off.
Well, I guess it wasn't a trick.
There's a lot of unanswered questions here. Did Duggan really mean to hit Lance Storm?
Boom.
Is Duggan
here
having second thoughts? Lance Storm just runs right over the Cat. Prime Time gets the boots in. It's going to be Storm and the Cat at Starcade coming up this coming Sunday. Oh!
Did he nice hop? Kick. He got him.
Tremendous super kick. Knocked him out.
What was he stomping
and
his
now
foot?
Now he's dropping him.
What was he stomping his foot on the mat for? Was he loading that foot or what?
Possibly.
You have a loaded tennis shoe?
Listen to the...
Oh, you never know. Miss Jones covers the Cat, shielding the Cat from further harm, but the damage has been done, and the Cat must regroup, must rebound, and Duggan's got a lot of questions to answer to Team Canada, to the fans, and of course, to the man right there, the leader, Lance Storm.
Miss Jones just got hit in the mug with a pie or something.
So many questions remain unanswered as we head into Starcade. Especially as for the status.
Wait, he's helping Duggan up.
Duggan.
Look, he's helping Duggan up. The Cat's helping him up, and the people love it. Listen to them. Listen to the ovation.
Maybe the questions will be answered at Starcade. It is the Sunday. Cat announce. You tell him, K-Dog. Only 4 days away. Thumbs up. Is Duggan coming back?
You betcha he is.
Rev up the holiday season with enhanced TBS Hardcore Holiday Sweepstakes. Two lucky Thunder winners will ride away with a Yamaha Kodiak automatic 4x4 all-terrain vehicle. To enter, log on to TBSSuperstation.com and click on Enhanced TBS to get your entry number. Then, experience Enhanced TBS during Thunder on December 20th and 27th and see if you're a winner. This holiday season, ride away with Yamaha and Enhanced TBS.
This is the Sarge, Wayne Bruce, working over the guys at the WCW Power Plant.
Scott Steiner, you didn't stick around to see the consequences of what you did to Kwee-wee. Plus, now Meng has asked for payback, and Ric Flair has booked the match. Plus, he's also given you the green light should you and Sid Vicious run into each other here tonight.
Yeah, I got the green light, and how convenient Sid Vicious isn't here. Travel problems my ass. He's afraid of me, and you're not going to be the first guy or the last guy to be afraid of me, Sid Vicious. And Ric Flair, what are you going to do when Sid Vicious is too scared to show up at Starcade? Where's your main event? See, you went on to hire a gun, but he felt the power, he felt the strength, and now he doesn't want me because he's going to go through hell at Starcade. As far as Meng wanting payback, Meng don't want payback. Flair wants me to lose the belt. He's jealous of me, but I'm going to kick Meng's ass tonight. No questions asked.
Big Papa Pump the Danger. Get ready. Starcade this Sunday.
Steiner's ready for Starcade, but what about this one? No holds barred, no disqualification. The streak is on the line. The man says he can do it. He's going to get another shot. The total package, Lex Luger against Goldberg. Talking about mind games, what about the mind games that have been going on with this one? It all comes to a head in only 4 days. Starcade 2000. Don't forget to get your Jeff Jarrett soap on that Slap Touch t-shirt by logging on to WCWgear.com. 1-800-929-8661. Great gift for the Christmas season that is upon us right now. And speaking of upon us, Dwayne Bruce, the Sarge, gets his shot right now, Mike, today.
Yes, Tony, this is a match, as we saw earlier tonight, that Mike Sanders, the commissioner, made the Sarge to go against the total package, Lex Luger. We'll take you back 1 week ago on Nitro, when these problems originally surfaced, Lex Luger and Goldberg. We saw the introduction of Sarge, the trainer of Goldberg, and then it was last Wednesday on Thunder, when Luger put Sarge up in the torture rack. And then last night on Nitro, Goldberg was forced to face his teacher. And yes, Goldberg scored the victory over Sarge to keep the streak intact.
Well, you know, Lex Luger's proved to be the master of psychological warfare, which is a dimension of him that a lot of people didn't know, but he's proving it.
Well, that's a great point, because he has gotten under the skin of Goldberg. And Conan, you know as well as everyone knows, if you can get an athlete off of his game, if you can take him away from his mental preparation, as the total package has done, you can have an advantage.
But do you really want to get Bill Goldberg like that? Do you really want to get him in that state of fury, that intense, that mad at you? It might work in reverse.
The total package, as we saw earlier in this telecast, not concerned in the least about a match against Dwayne Bruce Sarge.
You know what he told me in the back? He said that besides being the owner of a gigantic health club and having a huge estate that's guarded and gated and having a Porsche Cabriolet and turbo, that he wants a band, you know, he's just an everyday, nice, little, humble guy.
Just an average guy.
Yeah, just average, everyday guy.
Okay, I'm told that we may be able to talk with Sid Vicious on the phone once again and try to get through to Sid. See, apparently...
Guys, can anyone hear me?
Sid, I can hear you.
Can
where are you,
hear
at?
Me?
Where are you at? Are you...
Listen, I'm not real familiar with this area. I think I'm just a few minutes away, but I'm not sure. I can't hardly hear you. Can you hear me?
You break it up a little bit. You come to the parkway, and you turn left. The parkway.
I can't hear you guys. It's I'm going right to pull over and ask for directions, but I'll be there. I think I'm just a few minutes away. I'm not sure.
All right. Sid, thanks. He's breaking up, and he's on his way here. Scott Steiner, as we've already seen, is here. When Sid, and if Sid gets here, there is going to be another explosion, just like there was last night at the end of Nitro.
Oh, yeah, we can't wait. The CEO, Ric Flair, has taken the gloves off of these two individuals. He said we don't have to wait until Sunday at Starcade. They can settle it tonight here on Thunder.
I'll tell you what, if somebody can match Steiner for intensity and meanness and just downright nastiness, it's Sid Vicious.
Look at this. How insulting is this?
I got to. That's what I'm telling you. Psychological warfare. But Sarge is not some guy that just started out.
The fact is, and we saw it last night on Nitro, Sarge is afraid of no one. There are many people who have trained, who have gone to the power plant, who fear the Sarge. But he is one of the toughest men, pound for pound. Ask anybody. Ask Goldberg. And Sarge will not back up. He does not fear the total package.
He's chopping him down. Look at him. Luger gets too overconfident. He might lose with the way Mysterio did to Jeff Jarrett on Nitro.
He is just eating the stuffing right out of the total package. He was drooling that time for what the package has done not only to him, but has done to Goldberg.
He's actually foaming at the mouth. I think he's got gingivitis. But look at this. He's just chopping him down. Lex don't know what hit him.
Oh, look at this. He gets up and he knocks him down again.
He might be out on his feet.
Yeah, Luger's going to know who and what hit him after Thunder's over, as the Sarge has been dominant, believe it or not, in this matchup against the total package.
Well, let me Luger big, better come up with a plan. There's your plan up.
He hit him with a bat. He hit him, my God.
He hit him. He hit a human being in the head with a baseball bat.
And he's smiling. Look at him. Look at him.
And he's proud of
that
himself.
That SOB. I'll tell you what.
What an arrogant jerk. Unfathomable, what we just seen.
You cannot get more cocky than Lex Luger. Look at him. He's proud of what he's done, and he's getting under Bill's skin. He's doing what he wanted.
And that was the only offense he had against Sarge.
Oh, and he's going to take him up in
the dominated this thing in his academic right now.
He had all the bases covered here tonight. Thunder, including having that baseball bat underneath the ring. And there's the torture rack.
How brave is this man? He takes Goldberg out before the match, and then he uses a bat on this man.
He's cocky because you know Goldberg ain't going to come out. But you know what? At Starcade, it's going to be on and cracking. Luger and Goldberg, we're going to find out.
So let's drop him.
God.
Remember, Luger did this to Goldberg 2 weeks ago. Look at him.
As always, in great physical shape, though.
It's very easy to jump Luger, or it's very easy to jump Goldberg.
I bet you he's going to taunt Bill, and I bet you he's going to taunt Sarge. Watch.
And beat Goldberg to a pulp, and then a baseball bat on the Sarge.
You're bleeding out, Sarge!
Told you.
He knows good and well where Goldberg is.
Well, I told you he wouldn't be there for you, would he?
That personal duel of mental one-upsmanship, Lex Luger's taking it to a new level.
Where's your hero now?
We've never seen him this intense.
Yeah, or to
Where's
a new level.
Where's your hero now? Where is it?
I knew Lex when he was in the Wolfpack with me, Nash Sting, and you know what?
He's always had that in him.
He's always had it in him.
He's a self-serving jerk is what he is.
SOB is what he is.
Exactly right.
Always Scoble will come in here, bum rush him, and spear him.
He can't. Lay down in the back.
I wish he would, though.
Great strategy, though. Great game plan by the total package. You can't deny that.
On that piece of garbage.
You can't.
With that coward, Goldberg, nowhere to be seen.
Yeah, we all know. We all saw it. Lay down in the back.
You're next, Goldberg. Not me. And I can't wait till Starcade.
I have never seen Lex this furious. Look at him. Look at him.
Oh, look at that, mocking Goldberg. Is this the Luger that can beat Goldberg? Is this the man that can do it? He's got 4 days.
Yep, that's what he's doing. He's mocking him, sticking out the tongue, spitting all his trademarks, giving that crazy eye.
I like to enjoy the finer things in life. And I'm definitely the stuff. I've got my WCW MasterCard.
Get the official WCW MasterCard. To apply for yours today, just call 1-800-532-WCW2. Featuring new designs, great rates,
and all the benefits that go along with it. Get it? Yes!
To apply for yours, just call 1-800-532-WCW2 right now.
Back on Thunder, take a look at this. Goldberg's down, the Sarge whacked with a bat, and the total package like a thief in the night is leaving the building.
Hey, Sanders. Yeah, I'm talking to you, liver lips. You got a lot to say about my age lately.
What are you,
24, 25? Hell, I didn't even get into business till I was 35. Not in the ring, anyway. So, damn, I've been wrestling for 9 years. That makes me close to 20 years older than you. Guess what? I'm still going to kick your ass from one end of this building to the other. Thanks, Nate.
Reno, Vito, gentlemen, after what the two of you did to Bam Bam Bigelow, Kronik is not going to wait for Starcade. They want you tonight, Vito.
Yeah, you know something, Bam Bam Bigelow? You don't ever mess with our sister. Nobody does. When you mess with the family, you get your ass handed to you. And we ain't taking no prisoners. Bam Bam Bigelow, you got a taste of what Reno and Vito could do. Kronik, you want to step up to the plate? You go right ahead. You're going to get the same dose measure. And we don't have to wait for Starcade. We'll take care of it right now. And Reno, tell him what you're going to do to him.
What does he mean?
You know, Kronik, we know what it's all about being fired, how we did it half our life. So if you're feeling lucky, roll the dice and take your chances.
How about that tag team action that could have big implications here in WCW? Okay.
Trainer Danny Young checking with Sarge. It's one of that bat did not break his neck.
Okay, I'm sorry.
All right.
Okay.
Oh.
His ribs?
Yeah.
Well, his ribs.
Right through here?
Yeah.
That's from the torture rack.
Anything cracked or toddled?
I can't believe it. Monday night, everything blew up in my face. Spent all this time looking for an opponent for Starrcade, and I get Terry Funk, of all people. I don't know if I could handle that order, Dad.
What? That's not the crowbar I know. The crowbar I know will get out there and suck it to them. What's wrong? Do you lose your edge?
What the hell am I supposed to do?
Well, you can start by losing this cheesy hat. And these. And, we probably should give you those, too. And that shirt, and need some ripped-up jeans. That would be good, yeah. And maybe some grease on them or something, yeah. And where's your monkey wrench?
Coming up in a mere 4 days, Starrcade, the granddaddy of them all, at the MCI Center. 10 matches, top to bottom. What a night it's going to be. Let's take a look. Here we go. It's Big Sexy, Kevin Nash, and Booker T for the WCW title.
Stacy Exeter!
Oh, my God!
What did he just do?
What the hell did Stacy just do?
This is the ultimate swerve is what it is.
The Natural Born Thrillers are hammering Coach Nash.
Sanders, bring your jacked-up greenhorns out here, because in mayhem, I got a partner, and I want a shot at your belt.
Hey, jacked-up! Natural born monkeys! This is what it looks like when two older guys will be the tag team champions of the world!
Don't go getting too comfortable with those two belts.
Sanders, you can have those belts tonight, but at Starrcade, the perfect event, have got to wrestle the insiders one more time. Go home, brush them up, and get them nice and shiny for the insiders.
When Bill Goldberg viciously speared a fully sanctioned referee, he lost by disqualification, and Bill Goldberg, you're out of wrestling.
Could Goldberg's career be over?
He clearly speared Mickey J.
I have been reviewing the tapes all day. What Lex Luger conveniently failed to mention is the fact that he pulled referee Mickey J in the way of the spear.
Ric Flair made the announcement. Luger did not get his way. They're going to try it again at Starrcade.
You're next! Scott, I've got to explain something to you. WCW World Heavyweight Champion, conduct. You're not going to run wild. I want you to prove again and again that you are the man. And I've got an opponent to wrestle you at Starrcade. Who you got?
Oh, my God! It's Sid Vicious! He's the original lunatic. He's the original madman.
Sid, I command you to stop.
What do you mean to the word? Boomer! Sooner!
Son, your ass is going to jail!
Sid Vicious never lost the title.
I will rewrite history at Starrcade and take back what is mine.
This is the showdown we've been waiting for.
You, Scott Steiner, I said Starrcade. Wrong place! Wrong time!
Neither of these men will back down. Neither one. It's going to be a Starrcade that no one will ever forget.
Thunder continues, and you must join us for Starrcade. The brothers will be united together. Big Vito and Reno will face Kronik in tag team action. Vito and Reno came together just yesterday on Nitro. And then Bam Bam Bigelow will face that 70s guy, Mike Awesome, in an ambulance match. That's right. Two big matches for Starrcade this coming Sunday from the MCI Center. Speaking of Kronik, get your Kronik t-shirt now available on WCWgear.com or call 1-800-929-8661. It's all about Kronik, the t-shirt available for the holiday season.
Well, Tony, you just said that we were going to see this tag team matchup Sunday at Starrcade, but we're going to see it here tonight on Thunder. No need to wait to the pay-per-view event. Kronik on their way to the ring tonight to face Big Vito and Reno.
Well, you know what? Besides this being one of the best Thunders I've ever been a part of, this may be the best pay-per-view of the year as far as the lineup is concerned.
It was earlier this week on Nitro when Reno attacked Kronik in the hallway backstage. Reno's brother, Big Vito, ran in for the save until the Natural Born Thrillers arrived.
Kronik coming out, we understand, hired by Bam Bam Bigelow to do his bidding based on what? what Vito in Reno did to Bigelow earlier in this telecast when he hit on Sister Marie. And one can't blame him because Sister Marie is pretty darn hot.
Well, Bam Bam acquired the services of Kronik, and Bam Bam's hurt, so he paid these guys off to do his dirty work.
What must the Thrillers be thinking when they see Big Vito and Reno together?
Now, you know what? Big Vito and Reno, two guys that don't care. They'll go through tables. They'll go through whatever they need to do to get the job done. But let me just say something on a personal note. If my sister came to the arena, I wouldn't let her get involved in any of my matches.
Is this an Italian thing, having these two brothers join forces here, Tony?
Well, a lot of times in the Italian-American community, blood is thicker than water, but a lot of times in the Italian-American community, old wounds take a long time to heal. These brothers had a problem. It was Marie that brought them back together. And you can tell they've got all the looks in the family, can't you?
Yeah, Reno.
It was the girl.
So many big matchups at Starrcade this Sunday, including Conan. You're going to be in action as the Filthy Animals go in a Filthy Animal street fight against the Chosen One, Jeff Jarrett, and the Harris Brothers.
That's right. Jeff Jarrett, that country cranberry, brought the whole gang from Mayberry, Bloomberg, Goldberg, and all, you know. And we're going to find out who's who at Starrcade, because we got a special street fight waiting for them. And you're going to be surprised at some of the surprises we got for them at Starrcade.
Let me say this. The laxative thing that you did last night.
Isn't that beautiful?
That was too much.
That was beautiful.
That had the Harris Brothers literally running for the hills. Well, this, of course, Thunder, part of your enhanced TBS Hardcore Holiday. Log on right now to www.tbssuperstation.com and join us.
I'll tell you what, this pay-per-view is going to be great. Besides the world title match of Scott Steiner versus Sid Vicious, you got Goldberg and Luger, the 70s guy Mike Awesome against Bam Bam.
Wow.
I mean, these guys are going to be going up against each other, the Filthy Animals against the Harris Brothers and Jeff Jarrett. I mean, this is going to be a great one.
It's amazing seeing Vito and Reno working together as a team.
Never thought we'd see it.
I mean, when they first had this conflict, Reno, the natural born Thrillers, we thought they were mortal enemies. We had no idea they were brothers.
Now, I wonder if Mike Sanders is going to throw Reno out of the Thrillers. He's just going to leave, or what's going to happen on that one?
A lot of times you let a man take care of his personal, his family business, and then come back to the fold, so to speak. But look at Reno. He is one of the hardest hitters in all of WCW, as anybody. But that time, Brian Adams absorbed
look
those roundhouse
right.
Look at this gorilla press.
Well, you got to remember, he's a former powerlifter.
Oh!
Dropped him down across the knee, midsection first.
Marie looking in the background, doesn't like what she sees in the 1-2 and a 2-count. And that time, Reno barely escaped the wrath of Kronik. Adams will send him in again. Hired guns. Men for hire. Look at that. Reno picks him up.
Reno. Wow.
Wow, what strength. The scoop and the slam. Now putting the boots to Brian Adams.
Into the side of the hand,
he
Reno.
He's not intimidated by Brian Adams.
Not at all. Reno. Another man, another of the natural born Thrillers who made their way to the power plant under the guidance of Sarge Dwayne Bruce, who was brutally attacked by the total package before he ran out of the building.
No showboating, no wasted motion by Reno or Vito. They're just taking care of business. Nice quick tag.
Yeah, working very well together as a tag team here against Kronik.
Yeah, a lot of big man down.
A lot of continuity there, wearing him down. They are enabling
him.
Brian Clark to make a tag in. They are keeping now Adams in the ring here.
They're doing something very important. They're showing these guys that they will not be pushed around and they're not going to be intimidated.
That's a good call. That's always important. Reversal. And down he goes.
Phil Nelson slammed and just planted him.
And now Brian Clark will get the first tag in. And Clark coming in. Intimidation not showing that you're intimidated. It's very important going up against Kronik, kid. A good call.
Definitely. If they feel that you're buckling under pressure early, they're going to take it to you.
They're going to feed off of that.
They got that killer instinct.
It's a great call. They've set the tone already for Starrcade. The elbow takes down Reno.
1-2. Starrcade in the tone. Good call again, Mike. Has already been set for this phenomenal event. You know, originating once again from the MCI Center. And did he just feed him into the tag?
tag.
Yes, but
Vito,
you know,
why did he do that?
Let me tell you something, Tony. Vito and Reno, for having tagged up with maybe once, is this the first time they
first time we've seen
they're doing a pretty good job.
Very cohesive as
yes.
a unit.
Yes.
Well, they are brothers, but that was an incredible, unexplained move that time, because it seemed like they had Reno at their mercy, and they enabled him to make a tag to a fresh man.
Maybe he wants equal time with the other brothers. You know, they're about cashing checks and breaking necks.
So equal thrashing time, huh?
Equal thrashing time. That's what we're getting. And Vito hits the ropes, ducks low. The Mafia kick caught him in the sternum. Nicely done. Hey, quick cover, and he... Oh.
Way too early, way too early. He's going to take a bigger, more devastating move than that.
Not a bad effort, though.
Oh, nice suplex.
Yes, it was. Vito showing a lot of power reserve that time to get the man up and over.
They ain't showing a whole hell lot of respect for the Kronik boys, I'll tell you that.
Okay, they got him in the corner, double teaming the brother combination of Vito and Reno. And now here comes Reno in. A little sampling of what you're going to get coming up in 4 days at Starrcade 2000. We expect a great crowd on hand, and our fans in Richmond, Virginia are going to see you the very next night at the Coliseum for Nitro and Thunder. That is next Monday in Richmond, Virginia. Look at this. With a right over the bow.
Oh, nice. Jumping right on his head.
Oh, Marie with her hands to her face on that one, and a two count. And Vito's got 20 left now.
Strength that time by Brian Clark, just overpowering the opposition, and now sends him out to the arena floor.
Yo, if anything happens to Marie Brothers, I'll take care of it.
I would go with you on that one.
That's the type of guys that we are.
We are. Gentlemen at the...
Oh, hard into the guardrail, real hard.
Just moved the safety rail back.
Oh, what a chop. Uh-oh.
Life edge chops against the steel.
Vito trying to fire back. Oh, wait a minute. He's got... Is he going to... A Russian leg sweep.
Russian leg sweep into the guardrail.
Steel rail.
That'll break a man's back. Oh. That'll break a man in half.
These guys are putting all out effort. They're not even waiting for the pay-per-view. Listen to them. Boom, you can hear from right here.
What an experience here in front of the broadcast position.
Starrcade, this is that start. The start, I mean, everybody's getting ready for Starrcade 4 days away.
It's the Starrcade mentality. It's what it is.
How are you doing?
And I want to tell you, Vito, that time, it seemed like the Russian leg sweep against the safety rail woke him up. And he fired back up when we thought he would be in a crumpled heap at the base of it.
Nice teamwork here by Kronik. They have him neutralized in the corner. And Brian Adams brings him out of the corner with the snapmare.
And a rear chin lock to drive him down, maybe rethinking the strategy here. I'm sure they thought on the outside there that exchange would give them the definite advantage, but Vito
fired back. I don't think they expected them to come out this strong. I cannot believe.
Go.
Come on, Jared just knocked out Conan with the guitar, and he's got the Harris brothers with him.
They want to play their funny games. Well, Sunday ain't going to be no fun.
I guess the street fight is starting right now, right?
He just said Sunday's not going to be fun and games. It's a filthy animal street fight at Starrcade. He's out.
How long was Jared waiting for that moment?
He's not. I got to check on his
Mike, you, why don't you check on him, and we'll try to restore some order. Referees have come out. I apologize. We should be calling this match, but obviously with our broadcast partner down, we can't. Here, when you get this guitar out of here. Mike, did it cut him open? Yeah. All right, fans. Oh, well, it goes on here. You see Adams in the ring. One, two, no, and a kick out by Big Vito. Horrible thing that happened from behind. Conan, I don't know if he is conscious or what. It looks like his eyes are open. We got to get back to the match.
All right. He's going to be okay.
But they're going to help him off. Mike?
He had no idea. He never saw what hit him. That's the first question that he asked. What was it? Right. Who was it?
The fact is, the fans were shouting behind us, and I thought a couple of fans were in a fight or something. Double knockdown. The referee is up to four. Who can get their feet on this? As this match in the midst of this carnage rumbles on here on TBS 4 days out from Starrcade. Is that Is that street fight with the filthy animals going to be wild? And a tag made!
Oh, yeah, the heat was just turned up on that street fight Sunday at Starrcade involving the animals, as we see. Great move that time by Reno, taking the big man over with the fireman's carry.
Fireman's carry take over Reno, standing drop kick, nicely done, got off his feet nicely that time. And he goes after Brian Adams. Clark tries to get to his feet on the right side. Standing, running lariat, nicely. Oh, boy. Right on either end now.
Yeah, all four men involved in the battle here as Marie looks on from ringside. Referee has lost total control of this matchup.
Seemed to me that Reno may have hurt his knee on that exchange, but Reno's still on his feet. Nails Adams from my... Going for the roll of the dice!
Did he get him here?
Adams cut him off.
Ryan Adams, that time we saw the shoulder block employed, and now Kronik.
Yeah, if he hit that move, it would have been over, Mike.
Going to turn their efforts here, the double team.
They high time. No one kicks out from that, and Reno will not either.
What does that do psychologically to the team of Reno and Big Vito as they will get another shot at Kronik this Sunday at Starrcade?
Well, they're brothers. They got to regroup as best they can. It was a very physical match. You can see it from the reaction of Big Vito right there. He's going to try to get in to help his brother. Gotta wait for these two monsters to climb out of the ring.
Well, Marie got the two brothers back together again. But will that be enough to get them a victory? 4 days away when these teams meet again at Starrcade.
What are they trying to accomplish now?
More softening up of the opposition.
Oh!
Here comes Big Vito in with the kendo stick.
Yes, sir. He's got the kendo stick with the green, red, and white colors of Italy on it. And now he is hammering. He's not done. They wanted some more. He is up to the task here. Reno trying to get to his feet. Oh, no. Wait a minute. They've got the kendo stick.
And now Kronik turns their efforts to Big Vito
in that corner. Oh, right to against the ribs and now against the back.
Oh, no.
Look at the brothers continue to fight.
Can you stop?
Reno coming back. Reno's coming back. Security's been sent in. They're trying to pull this one apart. I don't know if they can. This is really broken down.
Oh, this is a long way from over.
And we're coming back. Look at this.
Every year, there is one event that rises above all others. One knife that destroys the past, defines the future, and twists around everything you thought you knew into a night you will never forget. This year, that event is Starrcade. You cannot imagine what WCW will do on its biggest night until you see it live. Order Starrcade, Sunday, December 17th at 8 Eastern, live and only on pay-per-view.
Close captioning were available on Thunder on TBS, sponsored by Wizards of the Coast, WCW Nitro, trading card game.
The WCW Nitro trading card game has even more ways to get slap happy on your friends. 11 card slap packs, add wrestlers and moves to your deck. The WCW Nitro trading card game. Get in the ring.
It ain't evident who I got tonight, all right? I got Dallas. You guys know that? Okay?
You do that.
Well, I'm a little bit concerned about it. You know what, though? I'll go out there and I'll do it. All right?
No big deal.
It looks like, I'll tell you what, though. We're going to have to resort to some drastic measures.
I like drastic measures.
You like drastic measures?
Set it off.
Somebody, I'm going to set it off. Somebody needs to wind up S-O-L.
And you know what that means.
Yeah, we know what that means. All right, Mike, today, earlier today, I had a chance to sit down with a man who will fight for the U.S. title in 4 days at Starrcade, the franchise.
Shane Douglas, what a long, strange trip it's been. After stints with all the national wrestling organizations, including WCW, last year, you returned to World Championship Wrestling. Why WCW? What did you have to prove here?
Well, I've asked myself that question so many times, Mike. You know, 20 years ago, when I first stepped foot in Dominic DiNucci's wrestling school, I knew that I wanted to be a wrestler. And then I knew after that I wanted to be a great wrestler. And then after that, I knew I wanted to be a great, great wrestler, perhaps one of the greatest wrestlers the sport has ever seen. Now, in order to do that, the Nature Boy Ric Flair so eloquently stated here so many times, and you know he and I don't see eye to eye on many things, but he has stated that WCW is the preeminent organization today, and the reason he says that is because all the pieces of the puzzle are in place here. every great wrestler is wrestling here, to prove yourself like I've wanted to 20 years ago and like I want to today. Every great wrestler is performing here in WCW, and I want to confront those wrestlers. And more importantly, Mike, I want to confront, because you know nobody in this sport has more skeletons in their closet or monsters under their bed than the franchise Shane Douglas. I want to look them square in the eye, those demons of mine, namely the Nature Boy Ric Flair, and tell them I'm not just afraid of them, but I'll confront them and back them down.
To this point, the WCW World's Heavyweight Championship belt has eluded you, but I get the feeling that in your mind, you feel that it's your destiny, that at some point you will wear that World's Heavyweight title belt around your waist.
It's drilled into my mind. I think about it each and every day, Mike. You see, when I stepped foot in this sport, I didn't step foot in to just be a lay-down guy. I stepped foot to be a champion. The WCW title I was bred to earn and wear around my waist. I am a thoroughbred in this sport, and until I have that gold around my waist, I don't have the exclamation point at the end of my career.
Last couple of weeks, you've been flying solo after your meal ticket was injured in that horrible accident involving General Rex.
That's where I'm going to interrupt you here. You see, I told you I'd keep my composure through this thing, and I'm really going to try hard here, Mike. You're a pretty intelligent guy. I've always believed that. So let me clarify you on a few things here. First of all, that meal ticket that you talk about, I've referred to her in the past as a meal ticket, so I want to make sure I'm really fair to all sides here. But she was so much more than that. She was my confidant. We were more than close friends, if you get my drift. I knew I could count on her each and every night, no matter what it was we were up to. That I knew where she would be in that ring, and she knew where I would be. I knew that if I needed her help for something, that she would be right there. So that meal ticket you referred to was just a little bit more than that, Mike. And as far as this accident that you referred to, come on, Mike. You know that that was predetermined in the back. She had no opportunity to not get hurt. General Rexion, Hugh Morris, did that on purpose. As I was reaching out for that U.S. title brass ring, once again, like so many times in Shane Douglas's career, yanked away from me. If we hurt her, he can't get the U.S. title. They were so wrong.
Your opportunity for revenge is now just days away, because at Starrcade, you're set to face General Rexion one-on-one.
Boy, you know, Mike, lesser men, lesser wrestlers, non-champions to be, would have folded under all that's happened to me here in the last 2 weeks. But like I said earlier, I'm a thoroughbred, born and bred to wear the WCW World's Heavyweight title, and I'll not stop until I have that around my waist. So instead of folding under all that's happened to me, I've taken all that frustration and anger and BS that's happened, and I've honed it into a fine point that I plan on drilling right into Hugh Morris's heart at Starrcade.
Almost as if the U.S. title, which is at stake Sunday at Starrcade, is secondary to the revenge you're trying to get.
If you're trying to get me to say that I'm looking past the U.S. title, you're wrong, Mike. This is a clear plan that I've devised from day one with my meal ticket that you referred to. I'm going to use the U.S. title just like every other wrestler here in WCW has historically used it, as the stepping stone, the footstool, if you will, right to the WCW World's Heavyweight title. Do you understand that?
Yeah.
You got that, Mike?
Yeah, I got it.
Professor, do you understand?
Loud and clear.
Then you understand where the franchise is coming from, don't you?
In just a few moments, Diamond Dallas Page. Look at this. It's the Natural Born Thrillers. What are they doing? What's going to happen?
Remember, Sanders said desperate measures.
He's coming to the ring, DDP, to face Mike Sanders.
Promotional consideration paid for by the following.
There's only one Goldberg, and only one book that tells it like it is about America's most unlikely superhero. Read I'm Next.
What is this? We're back at the Natural Born Thrillers. That was Paige's dressing room. What are they up to?
What's their plan?
And what were they doing in... Wait a minute. Wait, that's Kevin Nash. Nash has been laid out by the Thrillers. He's unconscious. They said desperate measures, Mike, and I guess they meant it.
And they delivered. Mike Sanders, above average. Mike Sanders, the commissioner, knew that they would need to stack the deck in their favor as he's set to go one-on-one with DDP Diamond Dallas Page.
Page must have no idea what just went down. He's on his way to the ring here.
How can he? He would have no clue.
Conan gets taken out, lacerated. Nash gets taken out. What is next? And Nash and DDP will never forget what happened last night.
Yeah, it was on Nitro where we saw Sean Stasiak nail Diamond Dallas Page with the championship belt. But then the big story is what went down after the match, as we saw the Natural Born Thrillers attack Kevin Nash and work on the previously injured knee that knee that has undergone so many surgeries, as we saw the Thrillers attempt to disable Kevin Nash, Coach Kevin, prior to Starrcade.
So you have tough Nash here coming back after all the surgeries. Flair, the boss, booked this one for the wake-up call. The commissioner, Mike Sanders, has his work cut out for him because Diamond Dallas Page is quite a fighter, one of the best ever, and a man who spends a lot of time in the community as well.
And DDP and Kimberly will be reading Christmas stories to the children at the Mall of Georgia coming up next Tuesday, December the 19th, 7 to 9 p.m. It's an event sponsored by 101.5 Kix Country, and it will feature country western artist Mark Wills. DDP asks you to bring an unwrapped toy for the Children's Restoration Network and Toys for Tots. There's more information available at ddpbang.com on the internet.
An update on Conan. He is being checked out by trainer Danny Young right now. He is going to be okay. We're not so sure if he has concussion or laceration, but you know how Conan is. He'll do anything he can to get to Starrcade this coming Sunday.
That is the key, and I'm just now receiving word from the back that Conan has already made it known that he will be ready for Starrcade. Oh, and that street fight. Have we heard from Sid Vicious?
Have not heard from Sid. Last time the cell phone was cutting out. We have not gotten word if he's arrived at the arena or not, but you know Scott Steiner is here. How volatile is that? Speaking of volatile, look at Page.
It's a powder keg just waiting to explode as we see Diamond Dallas Page connect with the knife edge chops, then drives the point of the elbow into the chest of Sanders.
Sanders reverses fields on Page, sending him in. Oh, Page, one step ahead. Sanders' head may be in the front row somewhere. Page clocked him on that one.
Sanders may have the advantage here. He knows that Kevin Nash is not going to be able to come out. Diamond Dallas Page doesn't know that. Clothesline, Page connects and takes Sanders up and over the top and down to the floor.
Page landed on his feet like a cat that time. He's so agile. Sanders springing off that time. Oh, the safety rail, Page giving chase. Oh, little water break.
It's been like a combat zone down here at the broadcast position this week on Thunder.
And isn't Sanders, it always?
Always. Sanders sent back first into the steel.
You know, I want to say this again, and I mean this about DDP. He has never looked better. All right, hold on now. All right, I am being told by our producers we do have Sid Vicious, but he is on the telephone again on his cell phone.
Can anybody hear me?
Sid,
where you at?
Where are you at? But
I don't know at this
point. Oh, no.
I know someone told me to take a right at the McDonald's and take a left at Wendy's. I don't know, but I know I'm close. If someone would just... Can you hear me?
Sid, we can hear you, and Ric Flair has said that you and Scott Steiner can... I don't think he can hear us.
But he knows Scott Steiner is here.
Oh, that's frustrating.
Meanwhile, a blatant kick to the groin by Commissioner Mike Sanders, who has Page down, and is hammering now Diamond Dallas Page. Just like we saw last night, you know what Sanders, even though he didn't want to go in against DDP, if he can take him down a notch, if he can mount an offense, maybe injure the man, then possibly Page and Nash will not be able, in any shape, to go after the World Tag Team title.
Well, Sanders showing zero respect, absolutely none, to Diamond Dallas Page. We saw on Nitro where they had injured Nash. They laid Nash out earlier. And look at the fire from Page.
How does DDP Mike do this? Come back many, many times over and over again. Look at this pickup. DDP showed a lot of power over the shoulder. Picked him up.
Gut wrench. Oh, that dropped him face first. Pancaked him.
Innovative offense by DDP. He's going to go for the diamond cutter, the coup de grace. That's going to be all. Front chancery first. Got him hooked.
He's got him. Which variation is it going to be?
Straight up. Oh, he got him down as the Thrillers come running down.
Oh, and remember, Kevin Nash laid out. Can't be here to protect Page.
Page fighting for his life. Another diamond cutter.
phenomenal kick that time by Sean O'Hare. Caught Page by surprise just as he turned around after he laid out Shindrack with the diamond cutter.
Can Nash come back for Sunday? What will Page fighting by life a jawbreaker? Nicely done in a great escape by Diamond Dallas Page. Starrcade. It is almost upon us. It's 4 days out. The Warrior, DDP, as he's done so many times, fighting for his life.
What an exchange here between Diamond Dallas Page and Sean O'Hare, and now DDP in the corner.
As great a fighter as he is, as Nash is, can even the insiders withstand the natural born thrillers of Starrcade this Sunday? Look
he's,
at Page.
He's still standing.
You're not kidding. Oh, wait a minute. Palumbo picking his shots, waiting for the right time. The tag team belt still around his waist, undeservingly so. And now he's hammering Page.
These are the desperate measures that the natural born thrillers promised us prior to this match.
Hold on.
No.
Page helpless.
Over
there. Sean. Sean.
Oh.
On the rib cage. The lower rib cage of DDP, maybe cracked a rib. He has had vulnerable ribs throughout his career. Can he mount a call? Look at this. A comeback from this. Now what are they going to do? This match is over.
Symbolically placing Commissioner Sanders on top of Diamond Dallas Page. Referee Silverman's not going to count this.
Second night in a row, the natural born off. They're going to count themselves. Palumbo with a three count. Second night in a row, the thrillers have decimated the insiders. What lies ahead for the tag team belt Sunday night? For the final gasp before we head to Starrcade, this is for the WCW title. Reminding you, this Saturday tickets go on sale for Monday Nitro and Thunder coming to St. Paul, Minnesota at the XL Energy Center. Monday, January 8th, you can meet Big Papa Pump in Medasia at the box office in St. Paul this Saturday when tickets go on sale at 10 a.m. And our next pay-per-view is Sin in January. That's Sunday, January 14th, the Conseco Fieldhouse in Indianapolis. Ric Flair will be at Karma Records on West 86th Street in Indianapolis this coming Saturday at 10 a.m. when tickets go on sale. We'll see you in Indianapolis. As Meng comes out and a chance to become WCW champion, a reminder, just in time for the holiday season for Nintendo 64. WCW Backstage Assault from Electronic Arts. You fight everywhere, not only in the backstage area, but everywhere around town. Get your copy of Electronic Arts WCW Backstage Assault from Nintendo 64.
In other words, it's just like World Championship Wrestling.
Yeah, it really is.
Earlier tonight, we saw the Monster Meng confront the CEO, Ric Flair, and demand this matchup. Flair made it official. Scott Steiner, Big Papa Pump, just 4 days away from Sid Vicious at Starrcade, has to defend the WCW World's Heavyweight title tonight in our Thunder main event against Meng.
4 days away, but how many minutes, how many miles away is Sid Vicious from this arena? Because Flair basically opened up the gates here tonight, opened up the door for Sid Vicious and Scott Steiner to go at it if they need be. Flair was tired of holding the men back.
And I thought we were going to hear from Big Papa Pump Scott Steiner. This one might be better.
It is now.
Ric Flair, seems like your best laid plans are going to waste. See, your hired killer, Sid Vicious, your hired gun, was too afraid to show up tonight.
I don't think that's the case.
Well, Sid Vicious, if you got the guts to show up in Starrcade, I'm going to kick your ass. No questions asked. I'm going to take you straight to hell. You don't believe me? Watch what I do to Meng.
Very common against Meng, and Meng will take the first blow on Big Papa Pump. The fact is that Sid is not too afraid to be here. Little travel problems, we all encounter those from time to time, and unfortunately, Sid, wrong place when they encounter the travel problems. And look at Meng!
Look at this offensive flurry by the Monster Meng on the attack in the early going, and he's got Steiner in trouble.
Yet though, will Sid be here? And when he gets here, if he gets here, how much of Big Papa Pump's gonna be left when Meng finishes his feast? He's rocking. Big Papa Pump is wobbly. He's almost like, oh, I thought he would be out on his feet.
Could we have a new WCW World Heavyweight Champion tonight?
Oh, this pickup.
Backbreaker that time by Meng.
One, two. You want to talk about changing the face of Starrcade? If Meng becomes a world champion, what would that do to the event Sunday night?
Well, this wouldn't be the first face that Meng has changed as he drops the elbow. Big Papa Pump very wisely rolls out to the arena floor to stop this onslaught.
There's a lot of brawn. There's a lot of carnage when you talk about Big Papa Pump. But we forget sometimes about the veteran Big Papa Pump. The many years he has spent in the ring, he knows what to do.
And of course, the reputation of Meng as being one of the toughest, one of the wildest men in the sport of professional wrestling, and that reputation is very well known as we see Medasia trying to get Scott Steiner focused on his opponent.
Yeah, it's the unquestioned reputation of Meng that everybody who has ever been in this sports entertainment business knows about. One of the toughest men ever. Look at this. A man, a float over who cannot be hurt. And he rocked down the head of Big Papa Pump.
Don't normally see that kind of agility. Don't normally talk about a float over when you see a match with Meng, do you?
Not at all. Will the Tongan death grip be the move that changes the course of the WCW title scene? Oh, no. Reverse neck breaker, nicely done. Again, the champion is in command. But where is Sid Vicious? Is he close? Has he arrived yet? We have not been given word. We are waiting because if he comes in, you know what he's going to do. He's been given free rein by Ric Flair, the boss.
And the time is running out. Sid Vicious promised us that he would be here on Thunder, and Ric Flair said that they were going to turn him loose.
Oh, thunderous clothesline. And look at this to follow it up with the arrogant push-ups by Big Papa Pump.
Oh, this could be a mistake against an individual like Meng. This mid-match workout by Big Papa Pump, Scott Steiner, losing his concentration.
Starrcade. The 18th year of Starrcade, it's only 4 days out. The world champion. When have you seen someone manhandle Meng just like this?
Never.
Never. He hoists him up, seemingly with ease. Scott Steiner, right now the world champion, wants to be the man heading to the granddaddy of them all this coming Sunday. Meng fighting him off. Repeated headbutts.
Scott Steiner, the master of so many different suplexes, it looked like he had one prepared for Meng. Meng fights him off and caught him with the clothesline off the ropes.
Meng connects with Scott Steiner, and Steiner's down. Paisley encouraging Meng, who asked for this match to continue the assault.
Meng airborne once, and he's going to go again. How many times have you seen this?
That's going to be it. One, two, no. Wow. The closest one yet. I believe the closest near fall that Steiner's had since winning the title in November.
Meng pulling out all the tricks, but that time the jawbreaker by Big Papa Pump stopped him, at least momentarily, extended the leg, and he took down Steiner.
At the foot up, Steiner comes back to his feet. Meng has not been able yet to use the Tongan death grip, but he realizes Scott is so strong in his upper body, around his chest, his traps, his neck, that it will take a lot to wear him down to get the death grip on. Staggers the monster. Steiner hooked him belly to belly.
Oh, wow.
Meng posted 300, a solid 285, and he gets out of that.
We talked about the array of suplexes that Scott Steiner can beat you with. Almost one with the belly-to-belly, and now sends Meng outside. This is where it gets so dangerous.
Meng up to the task. Medasia looks on. Safety rail. Steiner back first. Oh, back first of the safety rail.
Still.
Wait a minute. Look at this. Medasia on the back of the monster, and it got...
Oh, he shrugged her off, but then the clothesline by Big Papa Pump, as we see,
and Paisley
getting involved.
What is she thinking?
Oh,
running?
No.
Steiner should get out of my way, and Paisley, smartly runs out of the way.
What about Sid Vicious? Anyone in the back, have we seen Sid yet in the parking lot anywhere?
From his talk, he's eminent. He is in the area somewhere, but where? Into the corner, Mingos. Ducks. He's got a lot. Left, here it is!
He's got the grip!
And Steiner broke the grip immediately. He was waiting for it. Up Mingos. Oh. He T-boned him that time. Dropped him on his head.
Overhead release.
Well, guess what?
Wait a minute.
Sid Vicious has arrived. The music hits.
It's a Steiner recliner applied. Big Sid Vicious coming out. Referee calls for the bell. They said they were going to turn him loose, and here we go.
Sid comes out.
Oh, man.
Sid Vicious walked out. This is Starrcade. Just like they did last night in the parking lot, they're going at it here.
What impact with that clothesline? Took it down. The original American.
Send him into the ring. Steiner is still the world champion with the Steiner recliner. But how much does he have left for Sid Vicious? Sid and Steiner. Steiner and Sid, the foot hit Steiner.
He's got him reeling. Oh, he's got him. He's got him throttled. Can he take him up for the choke slam?
Just